Hello, my name is Ben. Would you like to learn something interesting about gold today? Excellent. What's your name? All right. So, I have a quick question for you. What's this? That's right. It is gold. So, I have some gold right here. This is just some gold foil and liquid. I want you to just tell me, what are some descriptive words for gold? How do we describe gold? Okay. It's gold in color. That's true. It is a metal. It's a softer metal, but still very hard. It's dense, so it's got a lot of weight to it. Okay. It's rare and it's expensive. Yep, these are all very good descriptive words for gold. Now, what do you think this is? It kind of looks like juice, or maybe even blood, but it is also gold. So, in here, this is actually called gold nanoparticles. Just like we have small pieces of gold solid floating in this liquid here, we have gold solid floating in a liquid here, too. But the gold solid is a nanoparticle. Do you know what a nanoparticle is? Have you ever heard of the word nano? Yeah, it means very, very small. We're talking about a billionth of a meter in size. Something so small that you actually can't see the individual specks of gold in here. But with the help of this laser pointer, I can show you that they're in there. So if I lift the laser pointer up, you can see all of the little particles that the laser bounces off of. So in comparison, if I have this vial just full of water, using as control, there's nothing in there, there's no particles of solid in there, so there's nothing for the laser to bounce off of. But if I hold them side by side, you can see very distinctly that there are gold nanoparticles in one vial, the red vial, and no nanoparticles in the water. Now the reason that gold becomes red at the nanoscale, or when it's a nanoparticle, is because it's reflecting a different light wave altogether. So bulk or macro gold is gold colored, and nano gold is red. Now that's just one of the many properties that are different at the nanoscale when we talk about gold. Another interesting property can tell us a little bit more about the food that we eat, actually. So here we have Pedialyte, which is like Gatorade, but for babies. We have Gatorade and we have pickle juice. And all of these solutions have electrolytes in them. Do you know what an electrolyte is? So electrolyte is like a fancy word for salt. It just means salt that your body can use. Electrolytes are found in all three of these things. Also, you know, Gatorade is famous for having electrolytes. When is the best time to drink a Gatorade? Yeah, like after you exercise or work out. So in that case, that's when, you know, your body needs those electrolytes back. So that's when it's best to drink a Gatorade. Now, one of these three solutions has more electrolytes than the others do. Do you want to guess which one you think has the best, the most electrolytes? Okay, so let's say that it was Gatorade. So what I'm going to do then is I'm going to hand you this vial here, and I'm going to fill it with nanogold. I'm just going to fill it about halfway with some nanogold. So there we go. You can see that it's got kind of a nice deepish red here. And what I'm going to ask you to do is I want you to put in the amount of drops of Gatorade it takes for the solution to change color. And I want it to count every drop. So go ahead and count with me. 1, 2. So we'll just go ahead and start with 10 and we'll see where we're at. Okay, so there's 8. We still haven't seen a color change. When we add up to 10, it's going to require a white backdrop to see it more distinctly. But there, do you see that? We have a nice purple color now. So this purple color indicates that all of the nanoparticles have clumped. And we can see that they are actually reflecting a different color light wave, and we get purple now. Okay, so that took us about 10. We'll set that one aside. And let's see what happens with the Pedialyte. So I'll add a little bit more here, just about halfway full, and we'll see. Do you think the Pedialyte will have more or less than the Gatorade? More or less electrolytes. Okay, so let's see. So if it has less electrolytes, it'll take more drops. So let's just start with 10 again. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so we're at 10. Still not a very distinct color change. We get up to about 15. Now we can start seeing a lighter purple color. So we know that Pedialyte takes 15 drops, Gatorade takes about 10 drops, Okay, so that means that Pedialyte has less electrolytes than Gatorade. Finally, let's see about the pickle juice, shall we? So, again, halfway. You may notice that I'm using a different pipette for each of these solutions. Why do you think that is? That's right, because I don't want to contaminate my fluids. That's a good scientist fact. So, let's see how many it takes for color change. 2, 3. As you can see, with only 3 drops, we get a very nice, distinct, dark purple-bluish color. So it only took 3 drops of the pickle juice, where it took 10 drops of the Gatorade and 15 drops of the Pedialyte. So which one of these solutions has the most electrolytes? That's right, the pickle juice does. So that means which one of these would be the best to drink after working out? That's right, pickle juice. Seems a little gross, but that's what the Nanogold shows us. Not that it's gross, but that it's full of electrolytes.